back. Josh Hardy here with Hardy Brothers Outdoors. Today we're getting ready to prepare some deer or venison backstrap for dinner for this evening. We're going to use a method called sous vide. So I'll tell you a little bit more about that in just one second. So I'm going to use a number of the products that I recently featured in my 11 products that I use in processing a deer video that was recently released. And this one, we're going to go back to that a little bit and talk about some of the key things that that I'm leveraging here. So first of all, I have invited over some family tonight to have venison. They're not all huge venison fans, so it's really important that I get my backstrap cleaned up, get as much of the silver skin off of it as possible. Any of the fat, that's the kind of stuff that tends to hold some of that gamey flavor. And this backstrap has been, fresh off of a deer about a week and a half ago, not quite a week and a half ago. So I've been, it's been aging in the refrigerator, hasn't been frozen or anything. And so we've been through and just kind of cleaned it up a little bit here with my boning knife. And the next thing to do is to seal this in a vacuum seal bag. And in that, I'm gonna, the recipe here is experimental. I haven't done it before, so hopefully by the end of this video, I'll be smiling and telling you how good it was. But basically, we're gonna do it a lot like how we normally do our steaks, but I'm gonna add some garlic instead of the seasoning that we normally use. We're gonna use some crushed black pepper, some pink sea salt, some minced garlic, and some butter. And we're gonna put each of those into the two vacuum sealed bags, and then we'll fire up the sous vide. So let's get this stuff into the bags real quick, get it seasoned in the bags, and then I'll talk a little bit more about the sous vide process. Be pretty liberal with the salt and pepper. I like the seasoning. This is going to have maybe 4 hours of time in the Ziploc bags or in the sealed bags before we actually cook tonight. So give a little time for the seasoning to work its way in. All right, so one of the things that I showed earlier was this vacuum seal. I've got an old Food Saver vacuum seal, and with it came this nice store and cut bag cutter. So I try to measure out, I got about the right size for it. Zip that off. Now I just need to seal one side, add my meat to the other side and seal it. And again, this thing, I've probably had it for, 10 plus years. So we'll probably do a new one, but right now there's nothing wrong with this one. So we're gonna keep using it. So for this part of the bag is towards the end of the roll. So giving me a little bit of fits there. So I can seal the bag. All right, got my bag sealed. Did a pretty haphazard job there, but I'm gonna get our back strap into there. Just going to throw in a teaspoon of minced garlic. Hopefully not too much, but We don't usually put that on our steaks, but we usually use like a garlic seasoning. So I thought we would just try that tonight. The opposite end, or I'm not getting sealed anymore. Alright, didn't have it in the right spot. So now we got it sealed up, and that's going to go right down into the sous vide and cook down in the water. We'll talk more about that in a second. Get another bag out here. So it's going to be a little bit bigger. Okay. The old back strap in. Didn't quite need to go so big on that one. Cut the same way. So here's how this works. This is called a sous vide. This is the Chefstep Joule. It uses an app on the iPhone or the Android. This is a heating element. It goes down into a pot of water and then processes the water in a circular fashion and heats that water to the optimal temperature. The steaks go in and we bring it up to, if we want them to be rare, we'll bring it up to rare. And then we'll do a sear afterwards on the grill or in a pan. And what this allows us to do is get the perfect temperature edge to edge without overcooking. And then we do a sear afterwards. So if you want it medium rare, it'll be medium rare from edge to edge. If you want it, you know, rare or well done, we go rare and then we do the sear to make sure we don't cook it too much. But when you cut into it, it's going to be the perfect temperature all the way through. Love using this for filet mignon, because it's so hard to get an even temperature on a big fat filet. So we'll show this kind of the process working here in a view of it afterwards. We've got some family coming over for dinner tonight. Hopefully they enjoy it. And we'll tune back in later after we've cooked these up. Okay, let's wrap this up. Dinner was a hit. Everybody loved the sous vide backstrap, venison backstrap. I think it was probably the best I've ever made. Kids loved it, and they're pretty picky. My mother-in-law, she loved it, and she's not a fan of wild game at all. Would tell you that it tastes gamey or whatever else, and everybody thought it was fantastic. So first step, make sure you get all the silver skin off. Second step, you know, any visible fat that you can get out of there is great. I think it helped that it aged in the refrigerator for probably 10 days from the time that the deer was harvested till the time that we had it. And the sous vide, I mean, it cooked to the perfect temperature. I think we could have gone a little bit longer on the grill sear. We were going to put it back on, but it actually turned out to be delicious. So it was a little bit, probably closer to the, a little bit to the side of rare than it was medium rare. But we cooked it like, I think right to 125 with about a 4 minute sear on both sides. So fantastic. I'll put a link to the sous vide in the description. It's a great gift idea, either for yourself or for someone else. We got it as a Christmas present from my mom, and we use it at least probably once a week, mostly on steaks, but you can cook all kinds of other stuff with it. So the link is in the description. Thanks for watching. Hit that like and subscribe, and check out a couple of our other videos while you're here. Thanks, and have a great day.